شهرٌ عظيم عظيم عظيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has given us another opportunity to be here today. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sahibul akhlaq al jameela, the one who has the most beautiful and honorable character. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend the blessings down to the companions and to everyone that is following the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until the day of judgment. Ikhwat al iman, my brothers and sisters in Islam. As a continuation of where we stopped yesterday regarding our Kitabul Adab, the Book of Manners, and specifically Adabu Dukhulil Khala, the manners of going to the washroom, the practices of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam whenever he goes to the washroom. Another point that is of great reference here is the manner of not touching our private part with our right hand and not cleaning up ourselves in the washroom with our right hand. This is because of the respect that Islam accords the right hand. And that is why Islam wants us to eat with our right hand and to give salam with our right hand and so on and so forth. But when it comes to things that are impure, things that are unclean, Islam wants us to use our left hand. This is why Abu Qatada, one of the prominent companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, reported that the Prophet said, La yumsikanna ahadukum dhakarahu biyaminihi wa huwa yabul. None of you should touch his private part with the right hand wa huwa yabul while he is relieving himself. Wa la yatamassah min al-khala'i biyaminihi. And none of you should purify himself, should clean up himself, should wash himself with the right hand while in the washroom. This is the command from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is very important that we put this in place while we are getting ourselves relieved. Another important manner to mention is the manner of not talking while we are relieving ourselves. This is based on the hadith of the Prophet sallam, where one of the companions came to him and he gave salam to him. Assalamu alayka ya Rasulallah. The Prophet sallam happened to be relieving himself at that time, so he did not give response to that salam. Some of the scholars posited that the Prophet sallam did not give response to that salam because he never wanted to mention the name of Allah while he is relieving himself. And some other scholars posited that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not respond to that salam because he never wanted to speak at all. They posited that it is general. The Rasulullah never wanted to speak while he was relieving himself. Either of the two positions, it is safe to say that it is makruh, disliked, to speak when we are relieving ourselves, except when it is necessary to speak, based on the principle that says ad-daruratu tubihu al-mahdhurat. Necessity makes things that are impermissible to be permissible. So whenever we feel the need to speak or to guide somebody or to say something that is very important while we are relieving ourselves, Islam permits that we can speak. But the basic ruling is that it is makruh, it is disliked to speak when we are in the washroom. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade us to face the Qibla or to back the Qibla while we are relieving ourselves. This is because solely because of the hornet position that Islam accord the direction of the Qibla. The direction of the Qibla is very important in Islam, and it is one of the symbols of Islam. Like we read to ourselves in the previous edition, ذَلِكْ وَمَنْ يُعَذِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. The one who shows respect to the symbols of Allah has really showed that he has taqwa, has really showed that he has the piety of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Coupled with the fact that one of the advices of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding this is that he says, فَلَا تَسْتَقْبِلُوا الْقِبْلَةَ وَلَا تَسْتَدْبِرُوهَا. None of you, whenever you go to the washroom, none of you should face the Qibla or back the Qibla. So, and also Salman Al-Farisi, the man that we quoted in our first video, part of the things that he said to the disbeliever that came to him to mock him is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us, Allah nastakbil al-qiblata wala nastadbiruha, that we should not face the Qibla and we should not back the Qibla while we are defecating. Then we move to the issue of istinja and istijmar. Istinja is cleaning up yourself in the washroom with water, and this is commonly used by everyone. But then in the event when there is non-availability of water, or when the water is not rushing, or when we are in the situation whereby we cannot use water, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already gave us another method, which is called istijmar. Istijmar is using dry materials like stones, dry leaves, tissue paper to clean up ourselves in the washroom. According to the rulings of Islam, we can even use istijmar even when the water is available, which is not until if the water is non-available, is not available, that we can use istijmar. So, and some of the scholars posited that we can use both istinja and istijmar. And this is based on the ayah of the Quran, which says, فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَتَطَهَرُوا. Allah was praising the people of Quba by saying that they used to like to purify themselves. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, why is it that Allah is praising you in the Quran that you purify yourselves? What do you do? Then they responded to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we used to do istinja and then we used to do istijmar, both together at a time. So this makes one to be extremely clean and to be extremely pure and to attain high level of purification. But then, whenever we want to use istinja, two things are very necessary to note. The first one is that we should not use bones or manure. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade us to use bones or manure. And this is contained in the incidents that happened between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. The Prophet told Abdullah ibn Mas'ud to look for three stones for him because he wanted to do istijmar. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was able to find two stones and he said, فَلْتَمَسْتُ ثَالِثَ فَلَمْ أَجِدُهُ. I looked for the third one and I didn't see it. So I took a manure. Then I went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallam took the two stones and returned the piece of manure and he said, هَذِهِ رِكْسٌ. This is impure. In another incident between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Hurairah, the Prophet told Abu Hurairah to look for three stones. Ibghini thalathata ahjarin astanfidu biha. Look for three stones for me. I want to purify myself. Then the Prophet said, Wala ta'tini bi'azmin. Don't bring bones. Wala rawtha. And don't bring manure. Why is it that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ask us not to use bones and manure? It is because of another report that says that huma min tu'amil jinn. Those two items are from the food of the jinn. So it is prohibited to use either bones of chicken, bones of cow, or any other bones to clean up ourselves, or we use a piece of manure. The second issue regarding this matter is that it is recommended to clean up ourselves an odd number of times or to use odd number of stones. This is because of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that says, إِذَا اسْتَجْمَرَ أَحَدُكُمْ فَلْيَسْتَجْمِرْ ثَلَاثًا. When any of you is doing istijmar, make sure that you stop on فَلْيَسْتَجْمِرْ وِتْرًا. Make sure that you stop on the odd number. So if you attain purity, if you think that you are pure on the second one, just do the third one to make it odd. If you think that you became pure, you attain the highest level of purity on the fourth one, do take another wipe and wipe another one, making five, so that it will be with you. It will be in odd numbers, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged us. Then in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yastanji ahadukum bidun ithrati ahjar." None of you should clean up yourself with what is less than three stones, which means that the least we can do is three. The least we can do, if we want to do istitma, is three. Of course, we can do more than three, but then it has to be in odd numbers, like we explained before in the previous hadith. So therefore, these are the practices of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding the going to the washroom. And let's not forget that whatever thing we do in followership of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our reward is definitely with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like he said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Indeed, it is in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a good example for you to follow. We'll stop here for today and we'll continue with another chapter of the Book of Manner in our next edition, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.